Tonight's curiosity is fueled by Good Neighbor Brewing Company's Iced Coffee Milk Stout. No tasting notes, but they describe it as a stout brewed with milk sugar, cacao nibs, Tahitian vanilla, and cold steeped with coffee from Little Sister Coffee Maker right here in Winnipeg. I was originally planning on waiting a few weeks before I did a teardown of this little robot vacuum cleaner, but my curiosity got the best of me, and I want to see what's inside it and why it doesn't work. I mean, it's entirely possible that the only reason it doesn't work is because I paid $10 for it on eBay, but you never know. Just to refresh ourselves on the features, this thing is called Sweeping Robot. It's 160 by 160 by 60 millimeters. It is a USB-powered sweeper, having such advanced features as automatic mode, edge mode, suck and sweep, noise reduction system, anti-collision, long life battery, and powerful suction. I discovered during the mailbag when I plugged this into USB, it did charge at about 80 milliamps for a little while, and then it stopped charging, so I assumed it was full. So when I went to power it on, absolutely nothing happened. So in we go. There are six screws on the bottom around the perimeter that I can see. And then there are these little brushes which I jammed on there during the unboxing video. So I'll get rid of those. I'll just quickly yoink these guys out. And let's see how it comes apart. Well, there we go. The top shell is just a top shell. Screws are dropping out. Ah, that's probably why it didn't start, because the switch is kind of jammed into a hole that it's not fitting in properly, and just sort of jammed diagonally. So let's see if anything happens when you push the button properly. Oh yeah, there we go. So we have the fan motor here spinning. We have these two spinning, which are the brushes on the bottom. And then we have this little wheel motor spinning both like that and like that. Okay, weird. So that was the fundamental flaw with it, other than, you know, just being cheap and nasty. So I'll set that back in where it's supposed to be, and hopefully that will work. Meanwhile, let's just look a little closer. We have one DC motor there with a worm gear on the front of it that drives this one. And then that meshes with this one. Those aren't even belts, they're just rubber bands. Anyway, they're driving those two side brushes there. And then at the back, we have another DC motor just onto this little fan impeller, which sucks air down through this little piece of mesh here, which means it's creating a bit of a suction through that slot, which is this slot here, which is on the bottom of the thing, and this little, cloth pad that sticks on that bit of Velcro there acts as kind of a brush, and dirt, I guess, gets jammed in front of there and pulled up into the slot, theoretically. And then in this little container here, we have the battery. Ah, pops out nice and easy. See what's underneath there. We have a couple of terminals. What's under there? Oh, it's just a couple of vents. Okay. 4.27 volts. So that is lithium ion battery in there. And it's wired directly to this little monstrosity. Unless this thing has a voltage drop or charge controller in it or something like that, then this thing is just going to be cooking that battery. I kind of like to open that up and just see what it is, actually. So after examining this battery a little bit closer, looks like it's welded together there, so I can't get into it without completely destroying it, which is a little disappointing. But what I can do is load test it and see what it really is, if it's got any value at all to be salvaged or anything else, or just used. So I've got my battery tester here set for half an amp, 500 milliamp discharge rate, and its low voltage cutoff threshold is 3 volts. So let's see what happens. And immediately when I turn it on, it drags the voltage down to 3.8 volts. So even half an amp draw is way too much for this battery. But I'm going to let it cook for a little while and just see what happens. Well, that didn't take long. The box claims that it's a 400 milliamp hour battery. My test says that it's closer to 109 milliamp hours, which is right in line with my assumptions about this device. There's nothing good about it at all. Not that I expected it when I bought the thing. Like I said, it was only, you know, 10 bucks on AliExpress, I think. Yeah, let's put it back together and see if it'll actually suck up any dust or anything. And finally, plug in the charger and see how long it takes to charge. At 250 milliamps, that should take not very long at all. And after less than 15 minutes, it has taken an entire 52 milliamp hours into the battery and won't take any more. Cool. Now let's see what it does. So if you remember when it was powered on before, oh, come on. Seriously? One moment, please. The wire to the power button broke. Didn't break off my solder joint, it just broke in the middle. Okay, now we're working again. Let's see if we can put this fragile piece of shit back together long enough to see if it actually does anything else. At this point, it should go without saying, don't waste your money on one of these. Okay, so it does go in a direction, and it does seem to randomly bounce around when it hits something. That's neat. So I'm assuming that this thing goes in a direction until it can't anymore, and then it does that and spins, I suppose. Right, well, I'm going to set this down on the floor and see if it'll pick up any junk. Because there's definitely junk to be had on this floor. Let's see what it does. Okay. It's sort of pretending to be a robot vacuum cleaner. It's chasing me around. Stop that. I'm getting dizzy running away from it. Well, I'm going to let it run around for a few minutes here, and then we'll bring it back up onto the workbench and see if it actually picked up anything at all. I have my doubts. Well, it ran for just under 10 minutes, and then it started going really, really slow. It hasn't stopped yet, so let's just see what's in here. Wow! To my surprise, it actually picked up a bunch of dog hair off the floor. Okay, that's cool. And what is that? Oh, that's a piece of backing from a label maker label. Okay, a bit of Kapton tape, a few other things. Huh, I am surprised. I didn't think it would pick up even that much. I mean, there's a whole bunch of other stuff still on the floor that it didn't pick up, like wire clippings, bits of wire insulation, bits of packaging and stuff that's landed on the floor right beside the garbage can, because I'm just not that accurate. But it actually did clean up a thing or two in the 10-ish minutes that it ran before the battery started going down and it started moving really slow. Surprising. Still, it's got a crap charging system. It is, in fact, not intelligent at all. It does just sort of bumble around and bounce off things. It likes to go in circles. It doesn't seem to want to get out of a very small area that I set it down in for whatever reason. And I think that is a reasonable recommendation for what to do with it. Anyway, that was fun and silly and satisfied my curiosity. Questions and comments down below as usual. I'll talk to you later.